Did you see my shirts?
Look at this here.
Cool.
Available in the link in the description below.
Hello, guys and girls.
We will check out today the Harley Benton JA60OW for Olympic White.
So here we are with the Harley Benton JA60OW, and the OW stands for Olympic White, for the color, okay? Olympic White, Olympic White. We got here a matching headstock. Really nice looking. I like matching headstocks. Yeah, let's dive directly into the specs. And we got a basswood body. Yes, it's a light body if I'm not wrong. The neck feels a little bit heavier. It feels like it could have a little bit neck dive. I'm not sure right now. We will see it later. A bolt-on neck from Canadian maple, says Thorman. Yes, we got a nice maple neck. Relatively thick neck. Feels like a C neck, yes. And it's a little bit on the thicker side. Comfortable still, but thick. Resonant guitar, feels nice. Rosewood fretboard with block inlays. Rosewood, really? Yes. This really seems like a rosewood fretboard. I really thought they would change it to Rose Acer or something else. But no, rosewood. And I cannot see anything bad here. Okay, maybe we got here a little glue line on this inlay. And it's a little bit rough here around the nut, but that's it so far. Otherwise, the fretboard itself looks nice, and they made the inlay well, good. Okay, the inlays are set in nice besides this little glue line here, maybe. 21 frets, yes, and we got no sharp fret ends. We got here a white binding, maybe that helps with this too, but they are a little rough on the top. I guess you can hear that. The scratching noise, okay? That are not my rough fingers, that are the rough frets. So they need a polish, but yeah, otherwise It seems okay. The action of this guitar came nicely. It's a nicely action here. We got here? Something around 2 millimeters and 1 point something here. And it's comfortable. I already checked that we got no dead spots or something. Yeah, so far really nice. 648 millimeter scale length, yes. And we got a 42 millimeter nut width. Seems to be standard stuff, especially the 42 millimeters on the nut. Double action truss rod, yes. And it works. So far, I guess. I did not make a turn on the truss rod, but I just say now it should work. Because the action is nice. We got a slight bow in the neck, the way it should be. So far, everything looks nice. Let me check here quickly the intonation. So no, the intonation is not right right now. But let's continue here. We got two Wilkinson MW90. No. What? So I was now a little confused. The Thomann side I got here right now says still Wilkinson pickups. No, this is the Roswell version, okay? They got two versions, one with Wilkinson pickups and one with Roswell pickups. And I got the one with Roswell pickups. I don't know what they are called right now. P90 pickups. And I will compare them in a different video to my other JA60 with Wilkinson pickups, okay? But yeah, I didn't play the guitar so far. I cannot say anything about the sound. We will hear it in a minute. One volume, one tone control, yes. And it got the same tint than the Roswell pickups, slightly orange. Creamy orange. And the tip of the three-way switch is a little bit, got a different tint. So this is not perfectly fitting together. Three-way pickup selector, of course, for the bridge pickup, for both pickups together, and for the neck pickup. Deluxe chrome hardware, yes, again. Deluxe, I don't know why they call it deluxe. It's a good-looking hardware. There are no complaints about this hardware. I mean, we got a tailpiece, a tunematic bridge. And the tuners work. They feel a little bit stiff, I have to say. Stiff in a good way. Sometimes on the Harley Bentons, they feel way too loose or something. But they are really, man, stiff. I really have to use some force to move them. Something I like more than loose tuners. And yeah, Klusenstein machine heads, like I said. Equipped with 10 to 46 strings, yes, I guess. The Dario strings, yes, I can see the ball ends here, the string ends. Case not included, yes, of course, there is no case, but Thomann got a case for it. And that are the specs from Thomann. Now, what else? This Salami Picard, I still call it Salami Picard. This is a 3-ply Picard. White, black, white, and on the last layer of white, we got this photo printed Salami looking, something. I would have preferred a cream pickguard or a black pickguard, but okay. For the price, you cannot complain. €129. Really great price, damn. Yeah, what else? The strap pins, standard strap pins. We got a white binding all around the fretboard. Nicely done. Not a little bit dirty maybe, yes. But that's it. Thomann doesn't tell us again about the nut. They always forget the nut. What the material we got here. And I'm not sure right now. I guess it's plastic. My guess is plastic, but I'm not 100% sure. The neck is set in nicely. No big gap or something. Overall, the quality of this guitar is really nice, especially for the price. We even got here slightly rounded fret ends. And yeah, the neck is a one-piece neck. The neck itself is a one-piece neck with the glued-on rosewood fretboard and white binding. And yeah, I guess that's really it now about the specifications. So, is everything recording right now? I had some issues. La! Are you there? Yes, you are there. Nice, so let's start. Okay, we are in the Bugera V22, into my Dozer cabinet with Jensen Falcon speaker, into my 11, mic'd up with an Electrovice CO4, into my 11 rack just as an interface, and into Reaper. We are recording into Reaper, and there is no equalizer going on, no high-pass filter, no low-pass filter or something, really the full range, okay? Now let's start, neck pickup, clean sound. Nice neck pickup, let's go to the middle position. And yeah, you guessed right, the guitar is easy to play. But let's go to the bridge pickup. And now quickly, neck, middle, and bridge, so you hear the difference directly, okay? Like it. It's fun to play. By the way, I will shoot a comparison between two JA60, the one with the Roswell pickups and the one with the Wilkinson pickups. Right now, I got the feeling the one with the this one here with the Roswell pickups is more, got more twang, you know, more spanky sounds. And I really like it. Okay, yeah, let's check out the volume port, neck pickup.
It works. Are we losing some high end? I think a little bit. And the bridge pickup. It works, the volume pot works. I cannot say a bad thing. Let's check out the tone pot quickly. Neck pickup. Too dark in my opinion. But a little bit up and it's usable. Yeah, so all the way down it's too much of the dark low. Here is a nice spot, I think. And all the way up. There we got the full spank again. So yeah, nice. The electronic works. And I cannot say a bad thing so far. By the way, the tuners work nice. I got no problems with the nut. I say it right now because I work here on 7 guitars right now. And I got, on some of them, I got some tuning issues. The nut slots are not right or something. But here, no. Guitar is easy to tune and it stays in tune. So now... Okay, enough clean tones, let's go with the vintage overdrive. And we got P90s here, okay? Can you hear that? They can get you some little noisy candy if you want. If you, yeah, you don't want it, but it can give you some noise. I just kept myself and always play like this, you know, chucky, chucky, chucky. I always got the feeling I have to play like this. Yeah, I really like it. Let's go with more gain here. The Harley Benton Ultimate Drive. Very easy to play. very easy to play. Okay, let's go with more gain. It works good with gain, really. Neck pickup. I can reach the last fret, but I got here this block in my hand, okay? But I can reach it. Enough. Yeah, but we are here in the higher gain regions right now, and yeah. P90 pickups, okay? Just to let you know. And yeah, let's go with more gain. Why not? Yeah, works good with gain. Yeah, man, I like it. I really like it. I like it. I like it. I like it. So what else? I will not go here higher with gain. Or maybe I should. Let's check out drop tuning. Okay, let's go with high gain one more time. I like it! What a great guitar. Great guitar. Absolutely steal, €129. And yeah, absolutely bargain. Must have guitar, to be honest, in my opinion. For that price, you cannot go wrong. You can't go wrong, okay? The build quality is very good. Maybe I should just start with the bad points. And the bad points are the rough fret tops, you know? The frets are a little bit rough. And the salami pickguard, this bad looking pickguard, is for me always a bad point. And maybe the neck heel, but you know, they just do it like the original, you know? But otherwise, I personally just see good points here. And again, for €129, okay? It's a very nice feeling guitar. By the way, it's not neck heavy. It felt like it's neck heavy, but it's just because of the shape of the guitar. The neck is a little bit more to the left side on my leg, and therefore I got the feeling it would, neck dive. But no, doesn't. Balanced guitar, 3.2 kilograms. And I dig the pickups a lot, really. I really like these Roswell pickups. In my opinion, they got more twang than the Wilkinsons. But like I said already, comparison will come soon. Tuners work, the nut slots are slotted good, the inlays are well done. Like I said, the pickups sound good, the action was okay, the intonation was a little bit off, but not a big deal. By the way, it comes with the tools for the truss rod. And yeah, the intonation was set up after a minute, you know, polytune, strum, oh, a little bit off here and there, and that's it. Very, very easy to play. I know I repeat myself, and I know some people don't like me repeating stuff, but there's a reason, you know, for repeating stuff. If I repeat stuff, it means it's important, you know, it's a big point on this guitar. And a really big point on this guitar is it's so easy to play. The electronic works, volume port works, tone port works, usable sound. Oh, I hit my mic here all the time. Ah! Come on, you mic, you. So now, no imperfections in the lacquer, really nothing. Not dirty. The fretboard was a little bit dirty. Okay, that's maybe a bad point too. But that's somehow a usual stuff on Harley Bentons. For some reason, the fretboards are dirty most of the time. But just clean the fretboard, polish the frets, and you got a very, very good guitar. Absolutely recommend it. If I would give stars, I would give probably something like, I don't know, 9 out of 10, 8 out of 10, something like this. And because of the price, playability, really good pickups, and the overall build quality is really, really good. Look again at the price. It's really, really, really a bargain. And yeah, no more rambling here right now. If you got questions, please come in my Facebook groups, Thomann & Harley Benton Support Group and Affordable Guitar, Bass and Gear. Really ask the questions there, okay? Yeah, I hope you like it. And that's it. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.